Boom. Look at the detail, guys. Come on. Look at this. That's, you know what? I think I need to make that my thumbnail cover right there. That is insane. So I'm going to show you two, maybe three reasons why I prefer Octane over Cycles. And stay towards the end because I'll show you guys a secret way just to really flip over between Cycles and Octane, literally one switch. If you guys are new here, my name is Patrick Lepore. I make videos for beginners using Blender Octane. Yes, Blender Octane is a thing and it's free. If you guys are interested in getting set up with this, check the links down below. It'll show you all these other setup videos and how to get into all that stuff. Enough of the jibber jabber, let's get straight into the video. All right, so here we go. Check it out. First thing first, all I'm going to do is jump in here and I'm going to add in a quad sphere. Okay, it's just a little bit easier to set up. I'm going to jump into my texture here and let's kind of split this up so we can see this. Let's go ahead and fire up the render. Render's looking tasty. There we go. So the first thing what I'm going to do is click on this, add a new material on here. And then what I'm going to do is just scroll all this down because I don't want to see all this, right? First thing first, we want to add some displacement to this. So what I'm going to do is come in here, geometry tab, jump into that. Let's zoom in so you guys can see. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on displacement. We're going to do a vertex displacement on this one here. Okay. Vertex displacement it's kind of like what's similar in cycles where you have subdivision, right? This is how much subdivision we have. Default cube. I didn't add anything, right? Boom. Okay. I'm going to jump out of that. I'm going to turn on auto bitmap, right? And then what I'm going to do here is add in a texture. You can click on here and add in a texture, but I already know what I want. I'm going to go shift A and I'm going to add in a noise texture, right? Just a standard noise texture. And then boom, there we go. We've got something happening. Okay. What I'm also going to do is this doesn't look too great, but hang on, let's add in our projection here because all noises, especially in Octane, you should have some type of projection on it. Because if I did any animation, this projection will not stick to it. The noise will just be floating right there and the thing will be moving around. Always have some type of projection connected to it. But here, what we're going to do is, you know what? You're like, this looks crappy, right? Okay, I know it does. Check this out. Let's add a level 4 of subdivision leveling. Whoa. Okay, did I just add some subdivision to it? Like, well, hang on, let's just jump out of here really quick and let me see how much subdivision I got going on the outside. Nope, there's still my normal subdivision, right? I didn't add anything else, but I did over here. Okay, we're in the dark arts of Octane, right? Straight out of a Harry Potter flick. That looks fantastic, right? So now what we can do is we can play with this noise here. We can play with our octaves, and of course, our noise here is going to change. For example, we can take our gamma. Let's go 0.5 on our gamma. And you can clearly see that starting to change. I'm going to add a little bit of color to this because it's blending into the background here. And I want you guys to be able to see all of this magic happening, right? We're clearly seeing we've got some nice detail. Like we get in pretty close, right? And you can still see we got some details, but I can start to see it break down a little bit. That's no big problem. Check this out. So let's see what else we can do. We got, let's go 0.7 this time, right? And see what kind of different noise patterns we're getting here. A matter of fact, we can even change the noise pattern. Let's go to like chips or something here. Boom, there's chips. Now I'm going to go ahead and take this back to 1. Let's take this maybe to 10. Ooh, getting a little bit crazy. How about we go 0.2 on this? See what happened? I mean, you see what I'm doing here? Like just the values, you got endless options here, right? All right, well, you guys can clearly see we can just have fun all day long trying to dial in a noise pattern, right? But I just want to show you the power of this. I mean, this is insane, right? So like if we wanted to get in a little bit tighter, hang on, I'm going to change up this scene a little bit. This scene looks cool, nice, but I'm going to show you some more power of why I choose Octane. So let me quickly jump over to my world shader really fast. And I'm going to add in this black background here so we can get rid of that background right there. Good. And matter of fact, we're just going to kill our world lighting. And then I'm going to add in just a standard light here. And then what I'm going to do is give that light a little bit more power. Let's jump back over to our object here. Let's go 150. That's looking nice and hot. And then check this out. This is one reason why, again, I love Octane. I'm going to go to the Octane camera imager here. And right now I'm using AGX, right? I'm going to kill AGX. Now here's just standard here. I can go to Aces color space, but we're going to leave it there. I'm actually going to try to play it up and show you some of the film looks that we have, film emulations we have built into Octane. Take a look here. If I come down here to, where is it? Right here. sRGB is what we're seeing right now. I can change that to all these film looks over here. We got these film LUTs. Like go ahead and just hold down control and we can scroll through these different film looks. Now these, of course, I only got this one yellow color in here, so you're not seeing the power of this. They're there back here. Look, we got Kodak Pantera Ektachrome, right? I mean, this is crazy. Kodak Gold 100 built in, straight in, and you can burn those right into your looks, right? And then we scroll down here to the fun stuff. If I go down into Octane post-processing, scroll this all the way down. Bloom, we need some bloom. I got you. Bloom, there it is. We need a little bit of cutoff. Okay, we can cut that off. No problem right here. Boom, there it is. We got some bloom. What about glare? You need glare? I got you. 20 on the glare. Boom, there's your glare. I don't like 3 rings. Okay, how about 4 rings or 5 rings? Or how about 1 for like an anamorphic look? Let's rotate it 90 degrees. Ooh, now we've got like this anamorphic streak. That is hot, right? Let's check this out. Oh, what are you doing, bro? You're shifting the colors around? Yeah. That's like some crazy scientific stuff that I don't even know about, right? We can even shift that around. Check that out. Come on, guys. That is sick. Then we can throw some chromic aberration in there. Who doesn't like a little bit of chromic aberration? Kind of a little bit, right? We don't want to go too crazy on that. And then we also got, what about lens flare? Well, let's go. Can we get some lens flare action? Oh, there's my lens flare right there kind of happening. See that lens flare right here? Well, let's adjust it up. Kill it off. We can shape it. You want to see more of the different types of shape? This is like, come on, built right in here. And like, boom, look at the speed. Look at the speed with this, guys. This is nuts, right? Running all this post-processing, I'm going to bring that down just a little bit. That's crazy. That's one of the reasons why I like Octane. I get so many questions on the internet, especially my Instagram. Dude, why should I use Octane? I'm like, why not use Octane? Right? The question is, yeah, okay, cool, why not? Because then a lot of people were like, well, yeah, you got to do it. Check this out. If I want to switch over to cycles, I bake this into my default setup. I'm going to stop this, right? And then I'm going to jump over here. Let me zoom in quick. Bing. Look up here where it says Octane. Check this out. Cycles. Boom. Right? Render. Boom. Now I'm in cycles. Here's my cycles nodes. Now I'm in cycles. Just like that, I'm in cycles. I want to go back to Octane. Maybe I'm working on a project. And I'm using cycle shaders and I haven't converted them yet. So I want to convert them over, which is not a big deal. It's for me, I literally press N and I'll come into, where is it? I'm in cycle, so I can't use it here, right? I need to go back over to Octane. Boom, Octane. And I have this, I actually disabled it right now. Octane tools will allow me to convert materials. If I go to add-ons, here I'm going to go to Octane tools. There it is, Octane tools. Turn that on, bada bing, bada boom. Octane tools right here. Convert materials. Zoom in for you guys. Convert materials. Let's scroll it out so we can read it all. Convert materials right here to Octane, to cycles. I can convert them right here. Boom. Right there. Just like that. Super dope. Okay. You can see the power that we've got with Octane is just, I love cycles. I'm not going to hate on cycles, but I like Octane better. And you know what? I can use both of them at any time, literally by a flip of a scene, and I can be running something else, right? So for me, it's not a big issue. Like, it's not a war. It's just another option. And I like to have more tools in my toolbox than just one hammer. Why not have two hammers, you know? And one hammer have its own special features that my other hammer doesn't have, right? You don't have to be so linear and single-minded these days. People are so single-minded. You can see me getting crazy right there. I'm playing with it a little bit more. Like, even if I got in closer, okay, I'm going to try to break it. Let's go. How low can we go? Let's go to 6. My 1080 right now is starting to scream. The fans are cranking up. It's heating up in here. Still up. I probably shouldn't touch. I may have crashed it. I cranked up the sub levels to 6, which is the highest. So again, I'm trying to break it. Let's see if we can lock it up. I probably should have went to 5 first and then 6. Ooh, no, it said shut up here, 6. Just give me time, bro. Just wait. Okay, boom. Look at the detail, guys. Come on. Look at this. That's, you know what? I think I need to make that my thumbnail cover right there. That is insane, right? And then don't forget how much subdivision we had on this here. We just had a straight default. Look at that. That's it. That's it. I'm done. Smash the like button. Smash the like button. I got a link down below for my Blender Octane School. I got a Discord down there. I got a Gumroad full of free stuff. Patrick LaVar, I'm out.